हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आईटीएलएस एकेडमी। आवर लेक्चर इज आइसोलेशन एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकाई एंड एंटीरोकोकाई। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। After completing this exercise, the student will be able to perform the following objectives. Number A is the beta streptococci. In this, we will see results of group A beta streptococci. First of all, we will identify an organism as a group A beta streptococcus or Streptococcus pyogenes and state the reason why when it is seen growing on a blood agar plate with a taxo A disc containing bacitracin. And after identification, we will recognize beta hemolysis on blood agar. Point 2 is the group D streptococci or the fecal streptococci. Results of the enterococci will include: first, identify an organism as an enterococcus and state the reason why when it is seen growing in SF broth or Streptococcus fecalis broth and on bile esquiline agar. Third point will include the pneumococcus. For the results of pneumococci, identify an organism as Streptococcus pneumoniae and state the reason why when it is seen growing on a blood agar plate with a taxo P disc containing optoquine. And after that, recognize alpha hemolysis on blood agar. Point 4 is the wiry dense streptococci. For this, state the normal habitat of the wiry dense streptococci and name three infections they may cause in humans. Also, state the hemolytic reactions of the wiry dense streptococci on the blood agar. Next point is hemolysis, referred to as the lysis of the red blood cells in the agar surrounding bacterial colonies, and is a result of bacterial enzymes called hemolysins. Although hemolysis can often be observed with the naked eye, ideally it should be examined microscopically using low power magnification, especially in cases of doubtful hemolysis. In the process of hemolysis, first point is beta hemolysis refers to a clear colorless zone surrounding the colony where a complete lysis of the red blood cells by the hemolysin has occurred. This is best seen in subsurface colonies where the agar has been established, since some bacterial hemolysins like streptolysin O are inactivated by oxygen. Point 2 is alpha hemolysis appears as a zone of partial hemolysis surrounding the colony, often accompanied by a greenish discoloration of the agar. This is also best seen in subsurface colonies where the agar has been stabbed. Point 3 is gamma reactions refer to no hemolysis or discoloration of the agar surrounding the colony. Point 4 is double zone hemolysis refers to both a beta and an alpha zone of hemolysis surrounding the colony. Many of the streptococci can also be classified under the Lancefield system. In this case, they are divided into a number of distinct serological groups on the basis of carbohydrate antigens in their cell wall. You can see here in this diagram, this is gram positive cocci. Catalase test is done. If catalase test is negative, then Streptococcus species, and it is grown on sheep's blood agar, and two types of hemolysis is done. First is beta hemolytic and second one is alpha hemolytic. If it is a beta hemolytic or beta hemolysis, then growth in presence of bacitracin disc. And if the alpha hemolysis is done, then growth in presence of optosyn disc. In the case of bacitracin disc, if it is sensitive, then this will be Streptococcus pyogenes, and if it is resistant, then it will be other beta hemolytic streptococci. In the case of alpha hemolysis, it is grown in presence of optogen disc. If it is sensitive, then it will be Streptococcus pneumoniae, and if it is resistant, then other alpha hemolytic streptococci. This all process was applied when the catalase test was negative. If catalase test is positive, then this will be staphylococci. This is a very simple and easy . Next comes isolation and identification of group A beta streptococci or Streptococcus pyogenes. First point is group A beta streptococci are usually isolated on blood agar. They produce very small white to gray colonies approximately 1 millimeter in diameter surrounded by a zone of beta hemolysis around 2 to 3 millimeter in diameter. Next point is there are two streptococcal hemolysins, streptolysin S and streptolysin O. Streptolysin O can be inactivated by oxygen, so more distinct hemolysis can be seen by stabbing the agar several times. In this way, some of the organisms from subsurface colonies growing away from oxygen. Since both streptolysin S and streptolysin O are active in the stabbed area, a clear zone of beta hemolysis can be seen. Next point is to determine if the beta hemolytic organism is a group A streptococcus, then direct serological testing can be performed. Alternatively, one can test for sensitivity to the antibiotic bacitracin. If we observe, then only Streptococcus pyogenes among the group A beta streptococci is sensitive to bacitracin, as shown by a zone of inhibition around a taxo A disc. Taxo A disc is a paper disc containing low levels of bacitracin. Next comes procedure, and procedure to be done in pairs. First point is take a blood agar plate and divide it in half with your wax marker. After washing your hands, do a throat culture on your lab partner as follows. Point A, depress the tongue with a sterile tongue depressor. Do not lay the tongue depressor down once you pick it up, and scrape the pharynx with a sterile swab. B point is streak about 1/3 of your half of the plate with the swab. Discard the swab in the disinfectant container. Point C. Spread the portion of the plate that you streaked with the swab over the remaining portion using a sterile inoculating loop. Point D is stab the agar 2 to 3 times in the streaked area with your loop. After streaking, stabbing, incubate at 37 degrees centigrade until the next lab period. These all points were included in point 1. Next comes point 2. Streak a second plate of blood agar with Streptococcus pyogenes for isolation as follows. Point A. Dip a sterile swab in your culture of Streptococcus pyogenes. Squeeze the swab against the side of the tube to remove the excess inoculum. B point is streak about 1/3 of the plate with the swab. Dispose of the swab in the disinfectant container. Point C is using a sterile inoculating loop, spread the swabbed area over the remainder of the plate. Point D is stab the agar several times in each of the 3 growth areas with your loop. Place a Taxo A disc containing bacitracin on the area of the plate that you streaked with the swab. These all points from A to D were included in point 2, streaking. Point 3 is incubate at 37 degrees centigrade until the next lab period. And the point 4 is do gram strain of Streptococcus pyogenes. The group D streptococci, the enterococci, and other fecal streptococci. First point is Streptococcus bovis and Enterococcus faecalis, that is formally Streptococcus faecalis, are the 2 most common group D streptococci that infect humans. Both are normal flora of the intestinal tract. Both of these organisms are among the most common organism causing endocarditis. Point 2 is most group D streptococci show alpha hemolysis or no hemolysis on blood agar. Although some strains of group D streptococci are beta hemolytic. Here comes the procedure, and this procedure is to be done in pairs. First point is using a sterile swab, inoculate the SF broth tube and the bile esculin agar sland with Enterococcus faecalis. Point 2 is incubate both tubes at 37 degrees centigrade until the next lab period. And point 3 is do a Gram strain of the Enterococcus faecalis. Next comes the pneumococcus or streptococcus pneumoniae. First point is streptococcus pneumoniae or the pneumococcus is a gram positive lanceolate coccus usually appearing as a diplococcus, but occasionally appearing singularly or in short chains. Pneumococci are frequently found as normal flora of the nasopharynx of healthy carriers. Next point is the pneumococci are the major cause of otitis media in children and sinusitis in people of all ages. In addition, Streptococcus pneumoniae is the most common cause of meningitis in adults and children over 4 years of age. Septicemia and endocarditis are also sometimes caused by pneumococci. Next point is the capsule serves as the major virulence factor enabling the pneumococcus to resist phagocytic engulfment. Pneumococci show alpha hemolysis on blood agar. Procedure for demonstration is observe the demonstration of Streptococcus pneumoniae growing on a blood agar plate with a Taxol-P disc containing optosine. Next is the viridian streptococci. First point is Several species of streptococci are known as the wiry dense streptococci. They are the dominant normal flora in the upper respiratory tract. Species include Streptococcus mutans, Streptococcus sanguis, Streptococcus mitis, and Streptococcus salivarius. Streptococcus mutans is the primary cause of dental caries. Wiry dense streptococci are responsible for between 50% and 70% of the cases of bacterial endocarditis, especially in people with previously damaged heart valves. Second point is, they are also frequently associated with bacteremia, that is deep wound infections, dental abscess, and abscess of internal organs. The wiry dense streptococci show alpha hemolysis or no hemolysis on blood agar. Do not possess Lancy field group antigens and can be differentiated from other alpha streptococci by biochemical testing. By this, we have discussed Viridian streptococci, pneumococci, and enterococcus. All of three organisms are covered in detail. So, thank you very much, guys, for watching this session. Guys, you can follow ITLS Academy on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp, and LinkedIn. For latest videos and updates, you can subscribe ITLS Academy on YouTube. You can also get the app of ITLS Academy on Google Play Store so that you can easily access all the informations and important updates directly and easily. Thank you very much again for watching. Guys, if you like the video, then like, share, and subscribe the channel ITLS Academy. For any help or query, you can call us on our helpline number, that is 7080@33450. You can also reach us on www.itlsacademy.com. Thank you very much again for watching this session.